Dr. Ahmed Fekry Abdel Wahab, you have the floor. Let me start by talking about the vision of the business community regarding business, doing business in the market. We have made a progress. Some people see that the policy stability is problematic. This is reduced from 21% to 15%, and this is a good indicator. What is reduced in the ranking is the stability, the government stability, which is always, which is also positive. However, inflation is very frightening. The inflationary rate increased, soared very high, and we feel this. It used to be 3.8% said that this is one of the problems of business, doing business. So it was reduced. Corruption also is problematic. So this is all related to the government performance, and it's so important to maintain our focus on these points. Let me shift gears now to some of the indicators which are important to highlight. Competitiveness. There is an improvement in our ranking in competitiveness, and we do have entities and bodies which are protecting consumers and protecting competitiveness. So I believe it's important to point out to the fact that our ranking increased from 127 to 188 on the local competition. The degree of market control also has improved from 103 to 51. But what really makes gives us a surprise is that the policies to reduce competition, our ranking in these policies is reduced from 100. From 78 to 115. So this is one of the things which would we would inquire about regarding our policies, how our policies were different. Dr. Mona is here with us, and she may comment on this or on how this happened. Second point which I want to talk about is that the higher education and training is a big problem in Egypt, despite the fact that our ranking shows some improvement in this matter, and our score also is improved. However, I'm of the view that it's important to pay due attention to vocational training, because we have a big issue and a big problem to find trained people. And this is reflected in the adequate supply and educated workforce. This is a huge challenge that we face. Let me speak now about something that was raised last year, and I also commented on it, on competitiveness, which is the fourth industrial revolution. I don't want this to be related to manufacturing in the real sense of the term. Yes, true, it is called fourth industrial revolution. However, it includes all phases and stages of industry, whether services or products. The fourth industrial revolution was highlighted last year. There's a book that was issued. It deals with this topic very easily by Martin Forth. This issue seems to us that it does not catch our attention in Egypt, because we are speaking about something that is very futuristic. However, in reality, this is very important. Yesterday, the Swiss embassy had a meeting with the attendance of ABB, and its main theme was related to the fourth industrial revolution and digitalization. And what was impressive in this meeting is that it included a big number of attendees who are really interested in this topic. So what is the significance or relevance of this topic? The speedy movement in and shifts in this field is more than what we expect. Let me give you an example. I work in the field of automobiles. Angela Merkel was speaking about the autonomous cars. That people think that this is something that may happen after 15 or 20 years. However, this is a reality. It is a reality, and we are going to see this, or I witness this, in the coming 3 or 4 years. It will be a reality, not only sort of science fiction or imaginary stuff. We have to be highly attentive and vigilant of digitalization and its implications and artificial intelligence and automation on the business environment and the consumerism. Why? Because this kind of development that is taking place in the field of automation is not only related to robots. People may imagine that this is related to having robots inside factories. On the other side, automation, digitalization, mechanical sensors are themes that are integrated into everything that we are doing. Paralegals, medical field, all these fields and domains are affected by artificial intelligence. Hence, many of the functions and jobs would be replaced by machines. Machines would replace humans, per se. Hence, the government should pay attention to this. Online ministers should be concerned about this. And since we live in a global economy, so the impact of this would be very tangible in Egypt in the coming years, very extensively and speedily, even more than what we imagine or expect. I would stop here.